Hey Notion fans, Ben here, and today we're going to be looking at filters in Gmail and how to develop a template for managing them. If you're anything like me, you probably spend a lot of time in your inbox, and when you get those newsletters, often it can be really disruptive when you're in the middle of working on something, and you might end up archiving those inbox emails and never actually reading that newsletter. I usually have the best intentions when it comes to reading these, but life gets in the way. So I've developed a system for filtering the emails out before they even get to my inbox so that I have a special inbox that I use to consume the emails all at once. So I usually like to read all my newsletters on Friday afternoon after I finish with my work. So in this video, I'm going to cover how to create what I call skip the inbox filters with your Gmail, and also how to develop a template to manage those filters in Notion. There's also a template that you can find in the description below. If you just want to grab the template and utilize it, you can do that too. Stick around to the end because I'm going to cover how I actually built the template in case you wanted to build your own. First things first though, do me a big favor and subscribe to my channel so I can keep making cool videos like this. Hopefully they're helpful. So to create a skip the inbox filter, we're going to start from Gmail in the browser, and that's at mail.google.com. And of course, right here, I'm in my inbox. Helpfully, I've got new mail to look at. And we're going to click on the little gear icon up here and click see all settings. And the next step is to click filters and blocked addresses. And down here, we're going to find this thing that says create a new filter. So these are options that we can filter on to do things with our email automatically when it gets into our inbox. And we are going to be using the from field to match the senders that are sending us emails that we've subscribed to. So let's say I subscribe to an email newsletter from a@example.com, and I also subscribe to one from b@example.com. Now, in order to create a filter that matches either of those, I need to put or in between the filter. So now I can put in, let's put in b@example.com or c@example.com. So this creates a string that matches any of those addresses and allows me to filter based on that. And so that's all we need to do. So you're going to be creating a string that has all of the emails that you subscribe to in this, and we're going to now create a filter. And what we want to do is skip the inbox. So I'm going to check that one, and that automatically archives the email. And what I would usually do is then click apply the label, and let's create a new label, and we're going to call this newsletter, plural, create. So now when we get an email from a@example.com or b@example.com or c@example.com, we're going to skip the inbox, we're going to apply newsletters, and I also like to never mark it as important because it's not, and I will categorize it as updates so that it goes into the updates. You might put it in promotions, but I like to put it in updates category. That's up to you. And then all we have to do is click create filter. And now anytime you get a email from either of those addresses, then it will automatically show up in the newsletters. And the nice thing about this is that you can mark it so that it's archived, and so you will never see it in your inbox, but it will show up in a label, which if we go to our labels in the sidebar, we can see newsletters here, and they will show up here. And that allows you to go to that inbox and find all your newsletters that you haven't read yet and go through them at once. They never hit your inbox, so you're able to keep your inbox nice and clean. To update filters, we go back to our settings and we go to filters and addresses, and we've got our editing here, and we just click edit, and then we can click and add a new address, for example, when we've subscribed to something next. And then I just click continue instead of create, and we just say update filter, and that will automatically now include the newsletters from d@example.com. And so if you're subscribed to, say, hundreds of different newsletters, you can see how managing this would be unwieldy, because every time you add or remove an address, you're going to have to reformat that or add an or at the end of it. So I built this Gmail filters template in Notion to help me manage the actual string that gets put in there every time. So this is my Gmail filters template. And if you want, you can grab this template link from the description of the video and put it into your Notion workspace by duplicating it. I do have some view and setup instructions here, which goes over what I covered earlier in the video in terms of setting up Gmail filters and skipping the inbox. And one way that you can manage that email filter by having the ORs between each email address is by using this template. So if you create this template and you just add some emails to the emails database, you'll see that this filter will automatically update to include valid emails in an OR string. So this allows you to, say, add new emails. So I might add e@example.com. And once that's validated, it will show up in this filter here. And you can see here that e at example.com is now shown up. So this is kind of a way of managing and being able to add and remove emails from your newsletter filter without having to manage a complex email filter in Google filters manually. So for example, if I deleted D, we'll see that our filter automatically updates to accommodate. So let's say I unsubscribe from D&E, and now I can go back, click the button, copy to clipboard, and be able to paste that into the filter to update it, which we covered earlier. Now, next up, we're going to show you how to build this from scratch. So we're going to build this from scratch. And when I say from scratch, I mean from scratch. So we've got a completely blank page here. Let's dig in and start by creating a new table view. So I'm going to type slash, and I'm going to type V to get to the views, put in the table there, and let's make a new database and call this email addresses. And I'm going to delete this tags property for now. And we'll put in some example emails here like we had in our template. And now that we got that, let's also create a view for our filters. And you can make as many filters as you want because they're just going to be related to these email addresses here. And we'll get into how to do multiples later. But to start, we're just going to create a newsletter one. And I'm going to change this into a relation. So let's edit this property. And we'll change from multi-select to a relation. And I want to relate this to the email addresses table. No limit. Let's show it on email addresses. It's called filters. Let's add the relation. And we'll close out of that. We'll delete these two, and we'll pick our three emails. And now if you remember from seeing the filtered template, we need to be able to turn this into A at example.com or B or C at example.com. So what we're gonna do next is we're gonna add a new property, and we're gonna call this one filter, and this is gonna be a formula. And to start, I'm going to open up my filter formula here, and I'm just going to select emails, and we'll see what comes out of that. And all that's done is it's turned my pages into a list of page names. So you'll see that the icon's gone, and now there's a comma in between each of these. And now you might wonder, how do we get to that OR step? Well, we can take the prop emails, and I'm going to highlight this and hit Command C to copy it. And I'm going to say, I'm going to use the replace all function. And what replace all does is it takes, if we look at the docs here, it takes a string, and then their second string is going to be what we want to replace, and then the third string will be what we want to replace the second string with. So in this case, it's replacing 1-2-3. It's replacing all the dashes with a bang, and that's what the result is. So we'll say replace all, and what do we want to replace? We want to take that list of emails that has commas, and we want to replace all of the commas with a space or space. Okay. And now we can see that we've got A or B or C. So if we add new addresses now, we're going to hit D at example.com. And we want to make sure we relate it to newsletters. And now D at example.com is shown up. And now in order to make it so that we don't have to pick the newsletter filter each time, I can actually hide this property, and we can change the filter here to where filter contains newsletters. And now any new pages I add to that will automatically inherit that filter so that we don't need to worry about selecting that one every time. And so in this case, I might go to the table here and I might call this newsletters because we might want to add new views for different types of filters later. So now when I add E at example.com, you'll see it already shows up in the A or B or C or D or E. And I can actually, let me fix that typo. Now I can actually copy that link to clipboard and I can paste that into my Gmail filter, and that will give me my formatted filter for Gmail. So in my original template, I've also got this additional step which validates an email address. In what we've built so far, I can actually type invalid in here and it's actually going to include it in the OR string. Even though it's an invalid email address. Now, you can get pretty fancy here. I've got another additional property on my email address database, which just has this very complex regular expression for validating an email address. So I'm passing the test function, the email, which is the actual title of this page, and then I'm validating it against this complex email regular expression. If it passes that validation, then it includes the email. Otherwise, it includes a blank string. So let's say I changed this to invalid. In this case, you'll see that the validated email is now blank. And you'll also see that that invalid is not included in our filter. If we open this up, we'll see that now the filter is actually replacing the commas in the valid emails property. And valid emails in this case is a rollup, which points to the emails and it's pulling through the validated emails. The interesting thing to note here is that you'll see that because that first one is invalid and it's a blank string, it does include a comma here. But just the way that property references work in Notion, you'll note that if I mention valid emails here, it actually just outputs B comma C. So it's basically making the array here into a string separated by commas, but you'll note that the empty one out front is actually ignored. So this kind of is a nice thing that we don't need to do some complex formulas or functions because there's no array support in Notion formulas, that anything that is empty will just not be included in that string. So that actually works out in our favor really well. So we only get B or C. And so if I add a new valid email, now that will show up in our string and we'll get B or C or E. And we could even add other invalid ones, not valid. And you'll see here that it's, even though it's connected, it's invalid, so it's not showing up here, and we're still getting a generally accurate OR function. So I'm not going to cover how to set that up, but if you want to add that following the instructions in this video, then I will grab the validated email function for you. And I'm going to actually post this right in the how did I build this. So when you go download this template, that function will be there if you want to validate your email using this expression. Just in this case, remember that the name of the email column has to be email, and then you'll get a email address or an empty string based on what's in that property. So hopefully this has been a helpful demo to show you how you can manage your Gmail filters a little bit more easily. Let me know what you think in the comments and enjoy reading your newsletters. See you next time.